improvements. These people have put in, this was actually postponed, and I didn't have any issues with the people that were brought forward that time, so that's why I chose to bring them all back.
But do you have, so my understanding, do you have a timeframe when it commences and when it expires?
I believe it goes into effect on 19th. I think we don't write about, but I think November 19th.
But you brought into the same issue, I think, that you did. I'm sorry, go ahead.
We did ask for that to be listed, and they have not got listed, so we said we don't ask to be able to start the 20th. Those, the current ones expire on November 19th. The new positions start on November 1st.
All right, so one of the things I did hear about, my opinion.
Yeah, that's why.
The council could have last time made that same motion. That for a term to commence on November 20th.
The new group would start on the 20th, the current expires on the 19th.
So that would not be in conflict, I think that's all. So if that was a previous one, we should change it in tomorrow's order. Do we approve it? Approvement? Okay. Yeah. I would say we would look to have someone amend, make the motion to amend the agenda when we go to approve it. For at the end where it says for a 1-year term to commence. Again,
November 20th and expire November 16th, 2022.
Yes. Commence November 20th, 2021. Somebody from the council have that? You got it? All right. Cool. All right. Cool. All right. I guess any discussion further on that? Mr. Mayor, 5.2.
And as we discussed earlier, you know, the 5.2 is a motion to appoint Brett Hall to the Compensation Commission for a 1-year term to expire November 16, 2022. In doing so, I wanted to kind of mirror that a little bit. So, but I did knock that down. I also knocked off the week of vacation, and I think there's something else. So it's similar but not the same. It's the chief of staff position that was brought forward in 2013. So the one, are you referring to like the 1 week? I think we changed that.
So D and E, in D under benefits five, under D, it says chief shall be credited with 40 hours of PTO.
Yeah, so coming in, our vacation starts January 1st. So being that it's November, him coming in, that's why there's a change. Like basically he has 40 hours of PTO time coming in, and then as of December 1st, he cannot, or January 1st, he cannot carry any of that over. He loses whatever he doesn't, but with the holidays and stuff, and I think he had a long weekend that we talked about or something like that. So anybody that knows Mr. Bzura, you know, he'll be living in this place. So, but I did want to give him a little time coming in to the end of the year. Now, whether or do I believe he's going to use that time, I don't, but coming into in November into January, I figured I'd give them a little sick time or PTO time. So it's basically a week buffer going into, but he doesn't carry over any of that if he doesn't use any of it.
Yeah, and just looking through, you know, cash payout or payout of 50% of unused time and sick time carried over. Years and understand, you know, where the city may or may not be in a contractual, but as a managerial employee, more and more company, I get to carry over zero. Mm-hmm. In many cases, you know, they don't use that time. So,
right.
Again, that's just, I'm going to go through it some more, but those are just some things.
Mr. Chairman, I will say I agree with you. But we have a lot of contracts that we're involved with right now, current directors that are have a lot more in them than that, because I actually did knock quite a bit down, and my goal is to chip away at stuff like that. You know, but as far as, you know, I want to be somewhat cautious on eliminating too much, you know, because we do. In my opinion, the amount of money that he's coming in at is low in comparison to a lot of, you know, positions and, you know, other companies and stuff like that. So, you know, I think the perks kind of help a little bit. But I thought the perks are a little too genuine.